president, do you plan to shut down the government?
That is a reporter shouting a question to President Trump as the Italian prime minister arrived at the White House today. So the president, among his many tweets over the weekend, C4, threatens a government shutdown in September if Congress doesn't give him funding for the border wall.
Now, the word coming out, Robert, is there have been negotiations kind of behind the scenes with the House and the Senate, Republicans and Democrats, Mitch McConnell, Paul Ryan, Nancy Pelosi, Chuck Schumer, that have been going very well. They've been agreeing on a whole lot of things behind closed doors. The one thing, though, they don't agree on, and they haven't put in, is money for the wall. And the president's getting wind of this, which is why I think his tweets are coming out now, because the funding package has to be passed by October the 1st in order for the new budget season to begin. And so the president is starting this. Now, you have Republicans, Robert, like Senator Ron Johnson from Wisconsin, other Republicans who are in states that might be at risk. And no, hold up, no government shutdown here. So this is going to be a battle.
A government shutdown in an election year.
Absolutely.
Ahead of a midterm election.
And Wisconsin, like I say, is one of those states that could flip Democrat.
I'm sure a lot of Republicans would love to see that.
Yes.
Let's talk about what else the president talked about, and you talked about it during your show today. He had his meeting with A.O. Schultzberger of the New York Times.
Publisher. Mm-hmm.
The publisher of the New York Times.
And the editorial
and
person,
too. And it was supposed to be off the record, but then
it was off the record, July the 19th.
Right. The president tweeted about it, and so Schultzberger responded, and he said, "Stop calling us the enemy of the people."
The thing is, Robert, like Sulzberger told the president, you can call us fake news. I don't like that, but you can call it fake news. That's not really too dangerous. But when the president says enemy of the people, that then not only nationally is a problematic for the media in general in terms of dealing with the public, but internationally. Reporters are finding themselves now, Mr. Sulzberger was telling him, under siege by despots around the world who are using the president's words, using his words, enemy of the people,
you also
to incarcerate, to target journalists.
You know, this happened, and I don't like to connect the two, but this happened supposedly the day that Jared Ramos, the shooter in the Annapolis Capital Gazette shooting, was due to appear in court. He didn't, as we've been reporting.
Right.
You know, as the five victims were remembered this weekend. I mean, this...
You can't help but bring it into it, but at the same time, though...
You know, it's not... Ramos's actions are not related to the president, but
But still, the president of the United States, Robert, should not be using language like this. He is the president. He's not private citizen Donald Trump anymore.
And it empowers people, you know, to harass reporters.
Exactly.
On the job. There's been a lot
of stories
about
that. And look, there's media bias. I admit that. Others don't want to admit that. But at the same time, call out individual reporters. Sulzberger said, call out the New York Times. Call out the Washington Post. But his generalization of enemy of the people, Robert, is problematic.
I want to turn to something else. And that is Nikolai Volkoff singing the Soviet
Memories,
national
Robert.
Anthem. Professional wrestler in the glory days in the 70s and 80s what was then called the WWF.
Vince
now
McMahon
WWE.
Was just getting started.
They were based in Owings Mills before they moved to Connecticut. They had a lot of matches at what was then called the Baltimore Civic Center. Now
and the Cold War was still going on at this time.
The Cold War was going on. It was in the wake of the Iranian hostage
1979.
Crisis. His partner was the Iron Sheik.
Who'll come out with the Iranian flag.
The Iranian flag. And he passed away this weekend. The interesting thing about it, his real name was Josip Perosevic, and he was born not in the Soviet Union, but in communist Yugoslavia.
Right, which is now Croatia and all that.
He was actually Croatian, but under Yugoslavia. And he lived for 40 years, more than 40 years in Baltimore County, was a code enforcement officer.
Ran for the House of Delegates.
Ran for the House of Delegates and lost in 2006.
Who wouldn't vote for Nikolai? That big scary man.
And it was interesting. He came in fifth that year. I don't know why.
I have no idea. Let's just raise some vodka for Nikolai.
Exactly. And Mr. Perosevic, everybody told me who met him and a lot of my friends.
What a nicest person.
Well, a wonderful man. Jimmy Seafood, he was a regular down there. They tweeted tributes this weekend. So rest in peace.
Iron Sheik and Nikolai. Thank you, Robert.
Rest in peace, sir. C4 back tomorrow, 9 to 1 on WBAL News Radio 1090.